you probably have heard with these big systems that the natural thing that governments and companies do often is they say, let's do a survey of best practice. And then we'll take all the best practices, and that's what we're going to build for our retirement system or other parts of our financial system. And I'm here to say to you, that's not good enough. Now, you mustn't tell anybody what I'm about to tell you, okay? It's just among us. But when I'm back in my native state of Massachusetts, I'm a very prudent driver, or at least careful driver, but I drive pretty fast. And so I'm going down the turnpike pretty fast, and I'm looking in the rearview mirror because I might be a little worried that someone may delay my trip, and I want to be aware if I'm going to have someone doing that. So I'm driving like this, and I suddenly realize I'm driving 33 meters a second, 100 feet a second, right? Looking in the rearview mirror. Now, if what's behind me and what's in front of me is the same, that really does work. But if there's a turn in front of me and I'm looking back there, it doesn't work very well. The metaphor here is that finance is high tech and it's enormously innovating. It is changing. It's changing for a whole host of reasons. So the road ahead is not the same as road behind. And best practice, by definition, since it already exists, is looking in the rearview mirror. So what institutions such as this can bring to the table is an understanding of what are market-proven technologies, because you don't experiment with your pension system. You don't say, let's do that you do in a lab or that you do in somewhere else. But if you have market-proven technologies out there, ones that have served the test of time in scale, they're often adaptable in ways that have never been used before. And we want to bring all of it together. And those institutions, countries that do this, will have the further benefit of leapfrogging current practice. And they won't have to do it again quite so soon.